Hello, it's Feathered Lamb, and this is my happy little accident. I was working on a different illustration, a Draw This In Your Style challenge, and when I finished this sketch, naturally it was time to move on to painting. When I picked the skin and shadow colors, I wanted to try them in action, see if they looked good together. But I didn't want to do it in the same canvas, so I opened a new file, I started to carve out shapes in the vague impression of a face. One thing led to another, and I thought the face was looking good. It had potential. I went to Pinterest, searched for a reference picture, and began to paint and render for real. So let's talk about why exactly I call it a happy little accident. Sketching is part of my process. I'm usually meticulous enough that my sketches are less guidelines and closer to line art. Part of it because I used to be a traditional artist, and that meant that most of my art, which you can find on my Buy Me a Coffee page, were made with graphite or mechanical pencil. And this medium, I'd say, mimics the sketching process from start to finish. Partly, I think, because there isn't a clear-cut separation, not like sketching versus rendering does. I would blend in many of my drawings by using blending stumps, but it wasn't all of them, and it was minimal for some. So my most comforting place is the sketching process, and perhaps it isn't just a comfort zone, but a crutch. It didn't feel like carving out shapes was possible for me. I had only tried it once years ago and it didn't go well. I couldn't understand starting to paint with no sketch to guide me along. I was always awestruck when I saw other people do it, but it seemed far out of my reach. Until it wasn't. Despite the fact that sketching is something that has always been part of my process, painting after has also always had a little bit of uncertainty, which I know is ironic. I found that I tended to have a lot of issues figuring out if I should paint right under the sketch or beside it, and I never quite figured it out, to be honest. I also tend to rush the sketching process, and sometimes figuring out the sketch can be tedious, especially in those days where things don't quite seem to align. But when you're painting, even if you are shifting things around, you are in the midst of rendering, not rushing to get to it as you would if you're sketching. Essentially, it provides a flow to the process as opposed to the natural break that is between sketching and painting. It seems that perhaps I was so used to the process of traditional graphite drawing that I was relying on something that, without realizing, wasn't necessarily the best for me. It was familiar, the only way I knew how, but it didn't have to be the end all. Of course, that's not to say that I'm never going to sketch again. Like Mama would say, don't spit at the sky, it may fall in your eye. But I've been having much more fun heading straight into the painting process. Will I carve out shapes in much more elaborate illustrations? If they are conceptual and original, and not just a study or a simple illustration from a reference? I don't know. It's hard to say. I guess the only real answer is I have to try and see how it goes. I think though that for sure, I'll sketch out architectural backgrounds. There's something about straight lines that I'm just not a friend of. Nature backgrounds are easy peasy, love them, but get me to paint a room and I'm tripping, stumbling, flipping, fumbling. All this to say, experiment. You never know if your status quo is the best for you. There might be a better alternative that is more helpful and enjoyable if you leave the confines of what you know. Keep in mind, experimentation doesn't have to be purposeful. The moment you do something different, even absent-mindedly, it can be an experiment. However, the only way how is if you don't let it pass by as a thing that happened, but rather reflect on what you did, what the process was like, what you liked and despised. Once upon a time, I thought painting without a sketch was something I would watch other artists do in wonderment while I sat in my lonely little corner with my never-changing, tired old process. But one day, instead of trying my palette in a new layer under my sketch, I opened a different file on a whim, started to paint, and finished an illustration. So my advice is to experiment, purposefully or by chance. I hope you enjoyed my little story about my happy little accident. Bob Ross would be so very proud. With any luck, this video was helpful to you. If you were already thinking of doing something experimental with a little trepidation, I'm cheering you on by the sidelines. Try out your experiment, and if it doesn't work, you can always revert to your original ways. No harm, no foul. And if it works, a new door has opened. Happy winter solstice and happy holidays. Thank you for tuning in. Click on the white subscribe button down below. You will know when you are subscribed when it turns from white to gray. Have a magical day and see you next year.